to go. Dr. Clayman is on his way, Dad.
Breezer, are you really afraid of needles?
Oh, not really. No, I just say that to encourage people that really are.
Well, they can use the help. The needles they use are about this long. It's a nerve when it's going into
your heart.
She looks perfectly harmless. She got nothing to worry about. Oh, sure. You hear the cage worry about someone getting an air bubble in their vein or the needle getting stuck in a bone and the tip breaking off. But that's the exception.
Oh, that's it. We're out of here.
But what about my flu shot? I always get a flu shot.
Well, you're not getting a flu shot today. You told me you'd drop me off at the Indies. Now, I told Duke I'd meet him at 5 o'clock sharp, and he pouts if I'm not there on time. Sits there with his bottom lip stuck out and eats all the Brazil nuts out of the bowl because he knows I like him. So come on, let's go.
Nice to know the men in bars still settle the disputes the old-fashioned way.
Dr. Craig.
Oh, Dr. Craig.
Sorry I'm late. My last patient was a bleeder.
Oh.
15 seconds.
Where are my manners? Perhaps you should get inoculated first.
Oh, I already had my shot, but I could sure use a checkup.
Folks, we're back. Joining us for this last minute of our show is Dr. Morris Clayman, who is going to give me my flu shot. But you know, what's the rush? Perhaps we'd be interested in finding out what strains of flu you've isolated this year.
Primarily Singapore, Rangoon, and Malayan. Would you roll up your sleeve, please?
And how do you suppose they traveled here?
No idea. Roll up your sleeve.
Could it have been a careless tourist? A baggage handler, a tainted walk.
Dr. Clayman, we're almost out of time. You do want to get that shot, don't you?
Yes.
All right, first I'm just going to swab the air with a little alcohol, and then I'm going to give you the shot. There, that's done.
Really? Oh, that didn't hurt at all. This is the newly immunized Dr. Fraser Crane, signing off.
No, that was just the alcohol. This is the needle.